Nollywood actor Yula Doce has disclosed that his wife never frustrated him when he had no sustainable job. Commenting on a post of a content creator advising men to get a sustainable job before getting married, Yula Doce said different things work for different people. And I think I totally agree. There's still a lot of very supportive women out there that, even regardless of what you have, they're still there to stand by you and then still do the needful when you can't. You get, they say there's always light at the end of the tunnel. So yes, maybe it's just a tunnel right now and there's going to be light someday. So just stick around. You never know. But hey, whatever rocks your boat, I ain't going to tell you to go and stay with a man that can't do like the basic things. Like there's something between didn't stress you when you did not have a sustainable job. Were you able to provide basic amenities? Do you understand? Like the basics.
Are you saying that you wouldn't advise a man to marry a woman if he didn't have, or if he couldn't provide basic
Basics. Like, no, the list.
What's the list? What's that?
I don't know. That's why I said, depending on what rocks your boat, what could be least for somebody else is relatable. It could be different. For,
I mean, there's least. General basic, which is food and shelter.
Yeah, food and shelter. At standard. Least it should be able
what,
to
then there's
not
levels
that.
To like what kind of food what kind of shelter.
Yeah, you
what's
get
in
it.
Your shelter.
Yeah, exactly. Now, those are the questions you need to answer. And if it works for you, then all well and good. But if it doesn't, say, smooth ahead. Don't nobody tie a big stone to your leg.
Absolutely.
You get me.
I think I liked his his response to the comments that prompted him to say what he said. Because obviously that person was trying to give a disclaimer, but in a generalizing tone, saying even when they tell you that they're going to be supportive, it's a lie, and that they're not going to be supportive, and that you shouldn't do it. Obviously, that sounds like somebody that is...
Bitter.
Maybe bitter is not the word, but that has gone through... Yeah. The exact same thing that he's writing about. And I don't think that means that the woman was at fault. A lot of the times, at least for Misha, you can think that you can handle something. And your intentions are right. Like, I want to actually be there to walk through this thing with this person. But when the going gets tough, sometimes you just realize that you're not actually cut out for this. And maybe it's affecting you more than it can. And there's some other things everybody will be like, how are you managing? But to you, it's like easy. So it really, really depends on context, the personality, the relationship and all of that. But I liked his response because then, I mean, this is Yul's response now. Because then it's saying that from, you know, an actual source who's been in the relationship, not just you and I talking, who's never been married. From like the I'm a living
who's
testimony.
Who's never been in a non-supportive relationship.
There's also that. But, you know, like saying that I was a testimony of that. I would, however, say, though, in the conversation of whether or not you should get married to somebody who is basically unstable, I think it's for both parties. And I know a lot of people don't think like that. In this side of the world, it's all about the man. But I wouldn't even want to get married if I wasn't, like, able to take care of myself.
Yeah.
Maybe not if I could not take care of... I might not be able to take care of both of us. But it could be that if you... God forbid, something happens to you today, you cannot work.
Have a fallback?
Like, can I at least even feed us for the day?
Right.
You know, or like, for the week or for the month, you know, can I actually feed us? So I think those type of things should be thrived for. But then again, it also depends on context. Sometimes people have a lot of support, which I wanted to say with Yul Adoche's part of the story, that even if he might not have not had a stable job, he might have had other supports.
Yeah.
Like his father, and I can imagine that he has also a supportive family in general.
That's what I said, it's related. Like,
it's very,
basic,
very,
like, it's just the basic things. I can bet that Yul Adoche would have been able to provide the basic, which is, like we said,
food and
shelter.
Yeah.
Even if he doesn't have a home, he has homes to go back to because he has family members in the industry that are doing
And I think it's fair to say that a man who cannot provide food and shelter should not
be thinking
about
marriage.
Do
you
want to
get married in your parents' house?
You understand?
Or
like,
do you
want to
get married in your friend's house?
Yeah,
it's not going to work. So you should be able to provide. So I think on one hand, we're stating the obvious. On the other hand, is also talking to a lot of men that tend, because you see a lot of these men that, okay, the woman is probably the one with the most money, who is doing the most. Probably you can provide the food and shelter. And because you are paying rent and you are providing food, you just get like, like really comfortable. Mm. You're not searching for a job. You're not chasing that contract no more. Mm. You're like, oh, my wife got it or my girl got it. And then you're not doing anything about it. So I think this is also a wake up call to a lot of men that you need to stay on your tippy toes. You get 10 toes always. You get like, you need to make sure that you are doing the right thing and trying as much as you can. This takes me back to that movie now. What's it called?
Acronym.
Where the lady was the one doing everything. But at some point, she got tired. There's a limit. There's a stretch. There's an elastic minute limit where you just be like, I can't do, like, I've been doing this for years. It worked out well for the guy at the end of the day. But will all stories end that way?
Yeah.
Will it always end up so good for every guy, even though they work hard? Because we've seen a lot of people that work really hard, but do not work smart. And they stay broke. It's just what it is.
Yeah.
See, it is just what it is.